Today we're opening a Chaos Box versus a Legendary Collection 2. What's up guys, we're back with another epic video, and in today's video we have another versus video. I was sent a Chaos Box by Doe Chasen on Instagram. Yeah, that's his name, pretty cool. But shout out to him for sending this in to be opened up. I thought it'd be a pretty fun versus video with this and the Legendary Collection too, because I did have a couple of these laying around, and these are always really fun to open. So before that, we have a giveaway. I'll be giving away this Ancient Guardians first edition booster box. All you have to do is like this video, be subscribed, turn on notifications, let me know what you think will win between the Chaos Box or Legendary Collection GX. So we are going to start with the Legendary Collection, because I think it is the favorite in the opening, and Chaos Box could be a little bit more random. So let's open up this Legendary Collection 2. I did check. I thought we had done this versus before, but I checked the playlist and like all my other videos, and I could not find a video where we had done this specific one. So I'd actually only done Chaos Box like 2 times in a versus series. So I figured that it'd be a pretty good one to actually try out, especially since Legendary Collection 2 is always entertaining because there's a lot of awesome like GX stuff. We have 5 packs. We got, of course, the old promo pack, which is worth about 10 bucks. So that's a good start for them already at $10. All right, so we have our 5 packs. Let's see what we can get. Legendary Collection 2. Hopefully some amazing pulls out of here. Some nice Elemental Hero alternate art, something like that. I think 2 from the back is usually what we do. We got a Mizuki with a common print. Okay. Crystal Beast Amethyst Cat. Elemental Hero Captain Gold. The 6 Samurai Yoriza. Destiny End Dragoon. Not the new Dragoon, the Red Eyes Dragoon, but we'll take it. Pretty cool. 5th Hope, a nice secret rare. Ooh, yeah. Beautiful. Ultimate rare of this also is very, very nice. Hydreigon, a cool ultra rare print. And Elemental Hero Ocean, which is also kind of nice. I think it just got a reprint recently, though, so not really that great. And then D-Spirit. So decent pulls there. Nothing too insane, though. Let's go to the 2nd pack. What will we pull? Let me know in the comments. Make sure to let me know. Will Chaos Box have a chance? It's going to be pretty tough. They're going to have some good RNG there. We got the Hero Volts. We got a Stratos. That's a few dollars already for the Legendary Collection GX. Just a common, too. Rise of the Snake Deity. We got Elemental Hero Neos. Always a common for some reason. Crystal Beast Sapphire Pegasus probably went up thanks to Crystal Beast support coming out soon. That is pretty nice. You love to see that. Gladiator Beast War Chariot. Nice secret rare as well. I think a couple of dollars. Gladiator Beast Octavius. I don't know if that one's very good. And then another Gladiator Beast Respite. So we are Gladiator Beasting it up everywhere. That's pretty insane. 3rd pack of Legendary Collection GX. Send your luck in the comments. Here we go. We got a Destiny Signal. That's a nice one. Evil Hero, not Elemental Hero. Infernal Gainer. The 6 Samurai Zanji. Very nice. Ancient City Rainbow Ruins. This has an ultimate rare print. I think it's Force of the Breaker. It's a really, really nice card. It's also really expensive, but that's unfortunately not that one. Destiny Hero Double Dude. We got an Evil Hero Lightning Gold, and that's a pretty sick super rare as well. Okay, next is the secret rare. Will it be a big one? So far, we haven't hit anything crazy out of the secrets. Let's see if we can hit something. Gladiator Beast Bestiaria. Another decent one. The Gladiator Beasts have a few dollar value. Ooh, Venomonaga, the deity of poison snakes. This now has a collector rare version, so I'm guessing the ultra is probably under a dollar for sure. And then Neospace regular rare. I think our pulls have been okay. Like, they definitely have not been great. We haven't pulled anything probably over 10 bucks yet, but it's a lot of like couple dollar value being added together, which will be hard for Chaos Box to beat anyway. Elemental Hero Flan Neos. One day we'll pull the ultimate rare of that. We actually have pulled it before, but it wasn't a PSA 10, unfortunately. Rottweiler, we have a system down to, what is this? Banish all machine types. Yeah, crazy against those cyber dragons. D-counter, sick. Elemental Hero Magma Neos. I think this is a couple of bucks. Gladiator Beast Equest. Okay, I have no idea if this is good. I don't think I've pulled this in a very long time. The artwork's actually really, really sick on it. Centaur reminds you of either Narnia or Harry Potter. Armor Tile of the Chaos Phantom, also pretty cool. Oh, Ruxus Special with the Destiny Hero Defender and the Elemental Hero Sparkman. Okay, interesting secret. I don't know what that's worth. Final Legendary Collection 2-pack. What will be inside? But wait, did you know that Mega 10 2022 pre-sales are out? Use my code MightyRuxin30 if you want to get $30 off with Sassiato's link. It also supports me as well. If you haven't heard about the reprints in these tins, they're reprinting Dark Magician Girl, Red Eyes, Dark Magician, and Blue Eyes with new artwork. And they're also reprinting a bunch of new cards like Red Eyes Dark Dragoon, Forbidden Droplet, Nibiru, Ash, Ghost Ogre, and many more. So make sure you guys use code MightyRuxin if you guys want to save $30 on your pre-order tin, and it supports the channel. So let's get back to the video. Send us some luck, I should say. Some actual good secret rares in here, hopefully. Wild Wingman, or at least one secret rare. It'd be an error if there's more than one. Neospatian Grandmull's a cool common. We got a 6 Samurai Yaichi. The Clay Charge. I thought that was a super for a second. Neospatian Glowmon. Where are the supers? Wait, I thought it was earlier in the pack. Okay. Dreadmaster super rare. That looks beautiful. I really like Dreadmaster artwork. I think it looks really, really cool. The ultimate rare is amazing looking, but this is just the super. What will the secret be? Gladiator Beast Secutor. Man, they love the Gladiator Beast in this opening. Secutor, I don't know if that's great or not. Okay. Light End Dragon always looks like it would be worth like $5, but it's not even worth a dollar, I don't think. And then Rosebud. So honestly, not the best Legendary Collection GX. So I think the Chaos Box might have a chance in this one. All right, Chaos Box, what can you bring us? Give us some good luck. Will we be able to win? Well, it's technically not me. It's Doe Chasen over here who sent us this. Will he be able to beat me technically? Because that was my Legendary Collection GX. This is his box. It'll be interesting to see if he could pull this out, because Chaos Box usually doesn't have too much luck because it only has 5 packs, 1 Legacy, 1 Mega, and 3 Booster Packs. So pretty tough to actually beat Legendary Collection GX where we get 3 foils every single pack, but it can happen and it has happened before. I'm guessing that Legendary Collection GX still probably had at least $30 in value at least. So let's see what we can do. We're going to start off with the Dark Saviors. It's some potential good cards in here. Let's see what we can get. It's just an unlimited pack. I don't know if the secret's at the front, so we're going to do this. It's only a 5-card pack. So 4 supers, 1 secret was an ultra. I can't remember. Supers. Okay. Shadow Vampire. Nice. The Helmer Helmsman for hire. Okay. Sky Charger Horned Drones. This is a good card, but I still don't think it's a dollar. Still very nice. Ooh, and then a Dyna Hero for hire. Nice secret rare. It's a cool card, but it's not very valuable there. And then another nice card, but I bet none of those even were worth a dollar. But some of them, these 3 cards are all pretty decent, but I'm pretty sure none of them are even $1. So decent start, but in terms of the value, it's at 0. But don't fret yet. We still have a few packs to go, guys. Don't give up. We have Maximum Crisis. Can we get the Ash Blossom Unlimited Secret Rare? I still think that would probably win the battle. Let's go. We have Zodiac Gathering. Okay, pretty cool. Magician's Right Hand. The Subterra Behemoth Fossil Hero Glacier. We're just going to pretend like that's how you say that. True Draco Apocalypse. Zephra War. Okay. This is Phantasm Spiral Wave. Not Ray. Lyrilisk Assembled Nightingale. Well, that was 3rd from the back. Okay. I don't think that that's going to pull it out, but Lyrilisk were good for a while, but they destroyed that deck. All right. I think we're still like a $0 value. Let's see if we can pull some good. Oh, Rising Rampant. Wait, this feels like a Euro pack. Okay. Wait, is this unlimited? Okay. No Starlights, unfortunately. We can still get Avalosa Ultra Rare or Secret Rare. That would be good because I think, for Starlights, you have to have a first edition pack. A lot of people don't know that. Unlimited packs have no Starlights. There's no such thing as an unlimited Starlight. So can't get this out of here, which you don't even see unlimited of modern packs very often anymore. So this was 2019. So honestly, 3 years ago, which is insane. But we got the Cross Debug. Let's see if we can pull the Opelosa. Marincess Current. We got the Dino Wrestler Rambarashio. We got the Defender of the Labyrinth. Is that a Link? I think I have seen that card because I remember this big fuzzy pink guy on there. But I never actually read that card. It's a Link card. Very interesting. Rescue Interlacer. Samorg Bird of Protection. Samorg Bird of Bringing. Wait, there should be a foil in here potentially. Oh, and then the Dream Mirror of Terror. Not an Opelosa that we're looking for. Okay. All right. Okay. 2 packs to go. So far, no value. So let's see if we can pull. That feels like the Legacy pack. Wait, no, that's a Mega pack. I think there's usually one Mega pack. So let's do the Mega Pack 2018 before we do the Legacy Pack. There's a lot of cards in here. We're just going to do 2. We got the Watt Kinetic Puppeteer. The Sniffer Dragon. I don't remember this guy, but that's weird. Okay. Dark World Brainwashing. Oh, creepy. Go Aristera Dexia, the Striping Partner. True Draco Apocalypse. Galaxy Worm. Double Resonator. Altergeist Sequitico, a Pendulum. I feel like I pull this every time. It's always Pendulum Paradox every time. It's not worth anything. Lee of the World Chalice Fairy Ultra. Okay. Trickstar Narcissus. Okay. All right. These guys are creepy. We always get that too. The classic Flick Clown with the sketchy name right there. And then the Hack World. Okay. Not the best Chaos Box so far. And finally, we're going to end it with, we need a big pack to have a big potential here. Okay. Invasion of Chaos. If we pull maybe CED, that could bring us back. Maybe BLS, something like that. I don't even know if that would have enough value, but it would probably still feel like a win. Let's see what we can do. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it's like this for the pack trick. All right. We have the Tower of Babel, the Fiend's Hand and Mirror, the Chop Man, the Desperate Outlaw, Chaos Necromancer. Can we get that CED BLS Envoy at the beginning? That would be an insane way to end this because the Chaos Box has been pretty rough. Legendary Collection GX wasn't that great either, so it has not been that good. Let me know in the comments. Can we do it? Sea Serpent, Warrior of Darkness. We got the Ryu Koki, very good card in a lot of old school zombie decks. Okay. Gigantus, another very good card, just classically. Curse of Darkness. And here's the last card. Here's our last chance to pull something insane and win this battle for Doe Chasen. And here we go. Oh, out, and a Dark Magician of Chaos in the final pack. So I don't think this one has quite the value to win technically by value, but this is definitely the coolest card we've pulled. So let me know in the comments, if you pull the cooler card, should you win? Like, should they just by default win the thing, even though the value's probably not going to be there? I'm going to have the values pop up on the screen right now so you can see for sure. Like, I'm just assuming we didn't hit the value. I don't actually know the value of this. It's usually like 15 to 20 bucks, but wow. That's a great way to end it. That's a heck of an amazing pull right out of the Chaos box with a random IOC pack, randomly amazing Ultra. There's only like three good pulls in IOC, and we just pulled one of them. If you guys enjoyed that video, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more epic content like this. Shout out to TCG Trusted Cards, Tonefo Show, Tomato Juice, Daxter, JT Cho, Puffins of Doom, Ernesto Deanda, Squirtle, Flexi Boy, Hoppus, Dizzy, Stanley, Mike Nance, Mimic Gecko, Ian Musa, Junior Barding, John Nolan, Anuntai Show, Thomas McLean, Seth Fisher, and Tone Z. Thank you guys for supporting the channel. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.